Welcome to the Rungu Virtual Test Ride. I'm Peter Godleski, founder and owner of Rungu. Happy to welcome you out here to someplace outside of Albuquerque, New Mexico, called Chamiso Canyon Trail. I believe I'm a little bit lost, and we're somewhere on one of the offshoot OHV trails. And I'm going to take the opportunity to show you, as many of you have requested, many folks on YouTube as well as on our website have requested, a virtual test ride, since we don't have a lot of places where you can do a test ride around the U.S. and we have interest all over the U.S. and all over the world. So we're going over some kind of sketchy terrain, frankly. And again, this would be not really impossible for an ATV, but we're taking it slow and easy. Dirt bike is probably a lot of fun for a dirt bike kind of guy. I'm not. Okay, let's take a path, not take less followed, I guess. So here we are. Imagine we want to go a little bit faster, but that's what's great about Rungu, is you can take it slow, take it easy, you don't have to make any unnecessary risks. Again, going easy, taking it easy, got some steps here. Oh, here's a good step. Alright, so we are a little wider on the trail than you'd be basically on a motorcycle, but you got a lot of, you got this extra tread to go over it, and it's kind of fun. So one of the nice things about finding Rungu is you really can take it easy. You're not sort of, when in doubt, throttle out. You've got a nice stable platform that even fits on these narrow trails, like this kind of bumpy motorcycle trail, which I think is called Coyote something or other. I guess they have them up here. Anyway, so you can tell it's bumpy. It's got lots of rocks and like these staircase features. And I'm taking it easy, power level 3, riding back, see if I can find my glasses. It'd be sad if I couldn't. A lot of cacti around here, it's not something good for your, oh, here we go. That's a nice little bump. And thing. So again, we're on a motorcycle trail. It's this section that you would no way be able to access with an ATV. It's really meant for motorcycles, hikers, mountain bikes, but it's super bumpy and technical. And Rungu's doing just fine. Here we are, back to the start. Okay, we're going to keep going down these. That's really the loose rock part of the trail, just because, just to show how easy it is. I mean, I really am not trying, you know, not the brakes aren't even on right now. As you can tell, I'm going over a lot of rocks. I'm going to stick to the looser ones just to prove the point, how stable and fixed your stability and control. Like, again, I could go over these other rocks, but we'll stick to the loose ones. Maybe we'll get a little side slip here. And just to demonstrate why you want a Rungu on these kind of conditions, because it's not going to wash out. It doesn't wash out on this, you know, we're on a... Go over right in the middle here. Again, really loose rocks. My front end, if you can't sense it from the video, is squirreling all over the place. No issues. Just no problems. Turn, complete control. Interesting when we talk about, you know, good fat tire bike, a little bit of experience, you do fine on this road, except when you don't think you're going to have a problem. So it tends to happen is that bicyclists or the fat tire riders will be riding on something really tough, really tricky, like we were, super in control. And then they hit a soft spot. Just a little soft spot, turn in the road. There you have a washout. And the usual thing is that the soft spot in the road, the little patch of dirt, loose rocks, place where you know, the gravel, where you didn't think you're gonna have a problem, that's always right next to a bunch of really nasty rocks. And so even though you slide out on the soft spot, you end up in the rocks. Ouch. All right, so we'll just do a little bit of technical stuff here. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, look at all this. Look at all these loose rocks right around it. Yeah, and I'm sliding all over the place here. So we'll go down here. Just follow these rocks. Let's go on the rocks. Rocks, rocks, rocks. No problems. Soft spot, no problems. Again, with the two front wheels, you're also able to go slower. So you have to pick your line a little bit better. And considering I don't have my glasses right now and can't find, and can see okay, but I'm not gonna see as well as if I would if I were wearing my glasses. Oh, we have another section of rocks. Okay, we'll go here, and then we'll go here, just to play around the rocks. And I'm sliding all over the place. No issue. No problems. And coming up, this was... And this is the point with that a lot of, you know, e-bike companies will talk about, like the... You know, both of them made in China. They'll talk about how that they can, you know, that just with skill, basically standing on the pedals, dancing on the pedals, as the bicyclists like to call it, you can make it through all this kind of stuff. However, it's the downhill that becomes treacherous. And like you see here, there's some nasty little sections. So you really have an advantage of being able to take it slow. I'm like, I didn't see what was going on over there. I can hit it, or I can go as fast as I want. Right here, look, loose stuff. What do we say about loose stuff? It ends up on the dirt. It's just to reiterate, it's usually places like this where things level out, it's easier, that your e-bike's gonna let you down the hard way. So we're in, we're off in the mountains behind Albuquerque, and Beautiful day, and we're riding down trail, off-road trail 472, which is an OHV trail, and you can, and there are these little offshoots that I took one, and then I realized that I forgot my glasses, which meant that I needed to go look for them again. And I think I left them, I'm hoping I left them in the car, because I sure as hell haven't found them yet. And again, like, we're going pretty quick. I'm going 13 miles an hour. I can ride on the crown, I can ride in the dirt. This is the easy section. And what many people forget is it's the easy sections where you wipe out. It's not the tough ones yet. You can wipe out too, but you're usually going so slow. I guess I'm on trail 462. So, 462? Okay. At some point this comes to a road. I recognize it. So here's nice, again, rocks. And it's like a little bit of off-road. Once we find our way, we'll go do some stuff that's truly off-road. This is kind of a moderate, or maybe even easy, off-road trail. It's actually really pretty here. And a bunch of these motorcycle trails. We took one called Cowbell for a while. And you can get it just to demonstrate. Okay, more rocks. So we'll go here just to make the point. I'm going to ride down this little rock, this section, just because you can. And oh, look at all this. Why would you do this on an e-bike, right? Gonna go right to the bird, no problems. So here's the start of the trail. Go down this weird rock thing here. Okay, where do we go? I hope to God my glasses are there. All right, really pretty. So again, I'm going gravel, no issue. Boom. This is the kind of place where you're going to wipe out. We're going about 20 miles an hour, and ordinarily, you know, you take one of these turns a little too fast. Put an e-bike on gravel, fat, you know, two wheels in front, you're gonna wipe out. You're gonna wash out in the front end. Unless you got skills where you're leaning back or just unlucky. I've seen plenty of super experienced guys hit the ground when they take that, they're in total control of their rig. Actually, the road's a little rutted here, so we'll slow down and we'll go off to the side again to prove the point about control off the berm. Oh, it looks like we're out of terrain here, so get up and over. So if I ride, this is no real good place to go here. I'm riding on the side of the road. Easy, but I mean, here we go, no brakes, gonna hit like 20 miles an hour, no problem, a little brake, we got a little wash there on the road,